Hey guys, the FitCon here. Today's vlog, we're going to be talking about what to expect on your first day in prison. Say you're unlucky enough to have been charged with a crime, and even more so unlucky to be found guilty or plea out, you're going to be spending time in prison. If it is over 2 years plus one day, you'll be going to the big house. Anything less than 2 years, in Canada, you're going to be going to serve provincial time, which is basically you're going to stay in remand or jail, as it'd be known in the States, and you're going to sit in there, which sucks. So you ideally want to go to the pen if you can, because there's better perks to being out there. You got your own clothes, a little more freedom. Generally, you're outside. Provincial time, not so good. So say you get sentenced, you're on your way to prison. You're going to get scooped from the prison early in the morning where they do their prison runs. The sheriffs are going to pick you up. It's basically guards in a wagon, and they're going to escort all of the inmates to prison. The inmates you might want to keep an eye for are the ones leaving separate than the general population inmates. Those inmates are generally PC, which is protective custody, and those will be guys who have either checked themselves into protective custody for reasons they're fearing their safety and well-being, for whatever number of reasons that might be. Generally, you're either a rapist, pedophile, or you're a gang member who has skeletons in your closet and there's people going to be coming to get you. So you're worried about your health, your safety. You guys check in, it's called, in remand or jail to PC, and you're going to spend time for the rest of your life being labeled PC, which is just not cool, so don't do it. Anyways, everyone gets thrown in the paddy wagon, you're all shackled up, and guys get escorted to whatever prison you're going to be going to. Most people nowadays start off in medium security, unless you're in on a murder beef or some higher violence related charge, then you're going to start right off at the max, which makes for a rough go right off the bat. But we're going to be talking today about the medium, because that's where I first started my sentence, in Drumheller, Alberta. Also started off another sentence in the max, or finished off that sentence in the max, but we'll get into that at later dates. So starting off in medium, you're going to go in intake unit, and that's when they'll be kind of monitoring you for about 90 days to see what you're all about, keep an eye on you, at which point they will assess you. Either you're going to go to minimum if you're lucky, you'll stay in medium most likely, depending on your charges. So when you get there, you're going to go to A&D, that's admission and discharge, at which point you're going to take off your clothes. They'll kind of sniff you out with a dog, make sure you're not bringing in narcotics. Some prisons have scanners, body scanners, so make sure you don't have any drugs up your bum. That's generally how guys bring them in. If you do, you're going to be sitting in a holding tank, and they're going to wait for you to shit it out. They're going to grab the drugs, zip it in evidence, and you're going to get charged with institutional drug smuggling, which is not the best way to start off your sentence, because you'd be picking up additional years for that too. So say you're not bringing any drugs in and you're smart, you're just going to come on in, you're going to go through A&D, you're going to get your little bedroll, which has your pancake pillow, a few shitty sheets, some horrible institutional clothing that you're probably never going to wear, because you're allowed to get your own clothing sent in after you're done intake, your pen pack it's called, where you can send a certain number of clothing articles in that you can wear throughout your sentence. And you get all that crap, basically. They're gonna send you to healthcare. You'll get your medication that you might be needing. If you're on any good opioids, though, they're gonna tell you you're not getting those anymore, or whatever certain drugs they do not allow in the institution you won't get. Some drugs you'll get in a pill-popping pack that you can take yourself every day. The hardcore ones, like methadone, stuff like that. Suboxone, you're gonna have to go up to healthcare every day whenever it's time to go get your meds, in line to grab your medication. So they're not just gonna give you a bunch of that stuff to squander in your cell. So after that point, they'll kick you off to the unit, at which point you'll get assigned a cell, probably with a cellmate for now, and they'll pop you in there. And say it's daytime, you're going to be either in school, in programs, or working. And if you're not doing any of those and following your correctional plan to get out of jail early on parole, say you're just sitting in your cell all day, that's not following your correctional plan, they don't like that. And you sit in your cell all day, do whatever you want, listen to music, watch TV. Some guys just don't really give a shit, right? So you're gonna get released out into your cell, and depending on what time of the day it is, you're gonna get locked up eventually for meals, at which point they do counts, number of times throughout the day. You'll hear the big alarm go off, lock up for count. At which point the guards will come door to door, check your name, see if you're alive, you know, if you're beaten up or dead or missing. And they're going to take inventory of all the inmates to make sure they're still all there. So at which point it's all good. You're going to get released unit by unit per four meals. You're going to go to the rec hall, or the dinner hall, sorry. And bring your cutlery with you, because you're going to want to eat something and they don't have cutlery there. And you're going to want to make sure you don't take somebody else's chair. That could be a beef right off the bat. And you're going to want to make sure you don't got any issues or enemies when you're rolling in there off the bat, because that's mealtime is prime time for somebody to roll up behind you and smash you in the back of the head with a rock and a sock, or stab you with an institutional shank or whatever kind of blade, right? So depending on the lifestyle you've lived, if you're coming into prison with a lot of skeletons in your closet, just be expecting to throw down on demand, because guys will be there to mess with you or to fuck with you. If you're going to an institution where people know you and they don't like you, and they're there already waiting for you to come because they read in the newspaper that you're going to do time, and they're just waiting for you, right? So in jail, people have nothing but time to sit there and ponder and scheme and whatever. So every time those doors crack and you're free to either go to meals or to work or whatever, be prepared. Some guys don't even take their shoes off, because that's when shit pops off, as they call it. So needless to say, anything can happen. But if you're just a regular Joe, say you're in on some fraud or driving charges or nothing too crazy, all you really have to do is just go in and mind your own business, keep your head down, follow the old school traditional jail rules, politics, which don't always apply nowadays because the jails have been integrated. And there is PC inmates mixed in with GP inmates all over the place. They didn't have enough prisons to house all the PC protective custody or piece of shit inmates anymore. So years ago, they started integrating them, sprinkling throughout the system. So now everyone is just integrated. That's the way it is. Now you can take it upon yourself to assault a pedophile or a sex offender on your own if you want, and pick up additional time and stretch your prison sentence to additional years or months, depending on whatever. But if you want to get in and get out, you're best off just keeping your blinders on and realizing you're surrounded by pieces of shit, and just not talk to or deal with them in any way whatsoever, right? Yeah, and if you are one of those inmates, then there's a good possibility you're going to have a rough go, because in jail there's a lot of contraband and there's a lot of people that love to do drugs, and for a very small amount of drugs, there's always going to be some kid in there willing to put in some work on you and roll in and smash you out or fuck you up or whatever for pennies on the dollar. I've seen guys get rolled on for $5, $10, pennies on the dollar. It's crazy, right? So that's what you're going to want to avoid, for the most part, unless you're in a position where it's unavoidable, because things you've done in the past are going to come up and haunt you where you're going. And that's just generally going to happen, because the prison world is pretty small and everybody in there knows everybody for the most part. And if they don't know you, they're just going to run your name, Google you, and see what you're all about. Anyways, after you're done your meals, which are generally horribly shitty food that you're going to have 3-week meal plans stretched out for the entire sentence, there's not going to be any differentiating factors coming into your diet. You're going to eat what the jail gives you on 3 meals per day. Base amount of shitty calories, nutrient empty food. It's all just going to be dense, crappy carbs, basically lots of bread, lots of mush, fake meat, no milk. The food's just really horrible in general. You're going to get that 3 times a day. You're going to eat it in there. You try and smuggle your food out, they're going to fucking charge you with that. You don't want to pick up institutional charges, because then you're not following your correctional plan and you're not going to get out any sooner than when you went in. So, not allowed to take food out of the kitchen, the dining hall, and you're not going to be getting extras. You can't want extra protein, extra meat. Myself, a bigger guy, is going to get fed the same amount as a 120-pound guy. That's just the way it works, unfortunately. So if you want to eat, you're going to have to figure that out on your own. We'll go into that in later videos, how you survive and how you supplement your diet while you're in prison, because they don't feed you enough to stay remotely strong or healthy, just enough to survive. They do have a canteen where you can buy food, but you can't just go spending all the money in the world. You can spend up to about $700 a year, I think, plus what you're making in there for wages if you're working. which is pennies again on the dollar, so you're not going to be balling. Basically, you got to hustle to eat in there, and there's always a hustle and a grind going on in jail. That's just the way it works in there. So after meals, you're going to have basically rec when you have the option to go to the gym, work out, get a pump on, or go walk around the yard. Whatever you want to get up to, go hang out with your buddies or just go socialize, whatever, right? And if it's your first day, you're going to want to be kind of questionable as to who you're running into, who's befriending you, and why. You know, there is a lot of piece of shit inmates in there. There's some good people, but there's a lot more negative ones than there is positive. So keep your circle very small and do your background checks on who you're hanging out with, because you might be hanging out with a guy for 3 months and then realize his name gets ran and he's in on a good charge now, but his last sentence was in there for raping somebody, and then next thing you know, you're associated hanging out with this piece of shit, and that's just not going to fly well for the general population. So in there, it's very primordial. It's human beings at a very dated, instinctual level, and it's basically the strong survive and the weak are victimized. So if you don't want to be a victim, you better stick to yourself, keep your head down, keep your blinders up, mind your own business, do not get sucked into any bullshit or politics, wheeling and dealing with other inmates, and you don't want to owe anybody anything. If somebody gives you something, it's probably not for free. You're going to owe that guy something, and if he comes to collect and you don't got it, next thing you know, you might find a piece of a pen or a little blade stuck in your neck for some reason. So a lot of things to be concerned about on your first day in, but if you survive the first day and they call lock up and you're there for count and you made it and you're locked up in your shitty little cell, generally without a TV until you get your pen pack, you're going to stare at the roof or read a book until you fall asleep. When you do get your property, which is when you're done intake, you can get a television, unless you can get a loaner up until that point, which you're going to have to rent or pay for. You can watch TV at night. So, yeah, that's basically your first day in. You go to bed, and then you wake up, and it's Groundhog Day. It's the same routine. 365 days a year for the entire amount of years of your sentence, or months, I guess, for some people, or decades for others. So, if you make it through the first day, you got to worry about surviving it through the second day. Every day in there is basically Groundhog Day, and things can pop off in a snap of a second. You look at somebody wrong, they might have a problem with you. So you don't really want to get too complacent, too comfortable in there. You're going to want to stay on your toes. You're going to want to stay healthy and conditioned, so if things do pop off, you're able to defend yourself and not appear like somebody who can be victimized, because there's people in there that prey on people like that, unfortunately. And that's just the way it is. So yeah, that's day one inside. Stay tuned for future videos, and we're going to go into everything else regarding the diet, how guys stay jacked in there, how you work out, how the drugs come in, and then other questions. Like somebody asked me in the gym today, do guys get raped in there? Yeah, they do, actually. It does happen. Not as common as it does maybe down in the States, but it does happen. So stay tuned for future videos, where we'll be bringing all the info as to what happens in the Canadian prison system, how you get in, how you get out, and how you get your shit back together when you're out, and how you stay out and not go back, which is what I'm on board for. So stay tuned.